Hey guys, welcome back. I'm sorry, I know it's been a minute since I've had a video up. I tried to forewarn you guys in my last couple ones that I've just had a lot going on lately, and I had a concern it was going to pull me away from certain things. So my apologies, but today I am in fact at my favorite Goodwill, and I'm doing a meetup today with Dina from Left Lane Finds. See if I, it's a tongue twister. Yeah, we're going to look around, see what we can find. But she's driven into town, and I'll introduce you to her here in just a second. We are here with
Dina from Left Lane Finds. I am a reseller and a YouTuber. Make sure to go to my channel. I'm sure Amanda will put a link to my channel down below. But
absolutely.
You'll see me commenting on the video too. And I can't wait to get inside the Goodwill to see if we can find the for profit.
That's right. Let's get in there. All right, guys. So we're seeing some familiar stuff. We saw some stuff right out the gate, but I'm gonna let Dina take a look at it. So green tags. No, these were blue. They're still staying. This is interesting. What is this? $7.99. Now I thought this piece was really cool. However, at $7.99, I just wasn't sure about it. You know, I think it has a little bit of age to it. Not a whole lot, but it's probably definitely vintage. It looked to be in good shape, and so maybe next time if that tag's on sale, I'll pick it up. So you guys know this is my normally favorite aisle down here. This looks like some flow blue. $3.99. Oh, I'm looking it over. I don't see any chips or cracks. Let me grab the other. It is. I think so.
That is really pretty.
I'm trying to see if they have chips or cracks on them, but let me set the, oh, I hope those don't roll.
Oh,
yeah.
That
would be bad. I don't think they have chips and cracks or are broken.
Oh, yeah. They
oh,
right
yeah.
There.
That's
right.
From probably the old plate holder.
Yep. Oh.
But
maybe
really
the one's
cool.
Okay. I don't know. Let's see. Is the other one on the back?
Oh, yeah. We could look at the back. I mean, fire and pin marks,
right.
But
I don't see any chips like the other one.
Yeah.
That's really cool looking.
I like it. I don't know what the pattern is. England. The mark looks familiar, but I can't place it.
I thought they just call it flow blue. But are you saying like the maker?
Mm-hmm.
Like the
yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and the pattern. You'll see all different kinds of patterns in flow blue.
Wow.
So the flow blue is just...
The style.
Yeah. Yeah. So the stenciling or whatever bled, the transfer print bled when
uh-huh.
they would fire it.
Oh.
And for some reason it caught on, and Americans really liked it, so
yeah,
they started exporting the crap out of it.
It's like popular.
Yeah, it is. I don't know.
See, I'm learning from you. I didn't know that.
I know very little, so that might
yeah,
be that might be
you
all
know.
You get.
So much more than I do.
I don't know. I might grab both. I don't know.
Because yeah, let me see if that's.
And I mean, they look like old chips. I'm sure they're from being hung.
They're on the back. Well, that yeah, you can feel it.
Yeah.
Bit.
And this one's 99 cents with the chips. Is this? They have $3.99 on the other one. Okay, I'll add in the chipped one for 99 cents. What is this? Oh, well, that's. I was expecting heavy. Not heavy. Not heavy at all.
I'm gonna go down the
other aisle. All right, I will come find you. What is this? That looks really pretty. Who made that? Island Plantations. I'm not familiar with that. It's a pretty blue bowl. I That's adorable. Is this broken anywhere? I don't see any breaks. The spoon has a little crazing, but Uh-oh, we have a rattle problem. Hold on. Okay. Let's go see if Dina's finding anything. We haven't found Dina yet. There's Dina. She's searching for something. Found a card?
Or the flatware. I like picking up the flatware.
Oh, yeah.
Usually it's not that. It's usually cheaper.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
I find it just depends. It's up and down,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's a cool looking old plate. Who made that one? Symphony by Salem.
Oh, yeah.
That's really cool. Okay, guys, we cut ahead of Dina. We're going to look at the end aisle real quick. What is going on with this goose? I think he's supposed to have a friend. That's cute. Oh no. It was broken, repaired. Right there. Otherwise, I probably would have picked that up.
I went through nothing but trouble to get my money back. So we don't really have any anyways.
Yeah.
Every once in a blue moon we'll get one.
What is he doing?
So you know it.
Yeah, I have a monitor.
That's cute.
So what do you have one to bring?
The frog that's missing his arm. Hey, is this like that other one that was up front?
Wish we had more, because I sure need one too. Afraid to buy it off Amazon unless it's brand new.
It's adorable.
You see one?
I thought there was one up front on that first shut, like down on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to walk up and see. Because it may not have been. He just may be in the same shape.
Check this out.
Oh, cool.
It's definitely somebody hand did that.
Oh, yeah.
It's pottery, but you know, it's got a heavy glaze on it.
Yeah, but is that. I guess that's ceramic, right?
Yeah. Oh, it's probably, it's not anything, it's not a heavy.
Yeah. It feels like an enamel sort of thing.
It's like someone painted a ceramic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, I like it though.
I think it's so unique.
Mm-hmm. It is. I like the contrast in it too. That's really cool.
First item in the car.
I know. I always kind of load up a few things and then I really sit and ponder them over later.
Yes.
Oh. What is that?
Small figure.
I bet you that's a courting couple on underneath of that. She has damage on her hand. Is that enough damage to say no? I don't know. That So this is a really cool old or vintage porcelain plate with the geisha girls on it, made in Japan, is stamped on the back. It's pretty well done paint wise. It's not too terribly sloppy and everything. I didn't see any immediate damage to it, but I did go ahead and end up leaving it behind. So that's a contemporary piece, but that's cute. Ooh. Not maybe kind of hard to tell in the video, but the reason I don't pick this up is because, especially right near the peacock, there was a lot of the enamel missing. Okay, so this one's got a phone. It's not marked. This guy's got a baseball and a turtle. This guy's a mailman. I don't know. What is that? What are these guys? $3.99. $10.99. Wow. Oh my gosh, it's all of them. And he's got a little triangle. Oh, his stick is broken. That sucks. I'm not usually a big advocate in picking up these pieces. However, that was a really cool one, and if his drumstick was not broken, I probably would have gotten him.
Well, let's check down the vases. Let's see. What do we got here? This one's still here. I wish it had a buddy. Because I would prefer to sell it as a set. But it is really cool. I love the colorway of that. Looks vintage, but it's contemporary. Oh my god, my mom would love that. It's contemporary, but she would love that. It's plastic. A little black glass container for $2.99. I don't know, I think that's pretty. Let's see here. Oh. Made in Hong Kong. Thought I saw a bowl out here that went with that. Maybe not. China. So contemporary. That's cute. You finding anything?
I found trinket boxes.
Oh, nice.
I never find trinket boxes.
Really?
Yes. And Brianna from Primrose Collectibles.
Yeah.
She finds them all the time.
Yeah. She even had a trinket box sale recently.
Yeah. And these are 50% off the green tag.
Yeah. Nice.
That one isn't, but that's okay.
Those are cute too.
It's a Nesca. It's a vintage little heart shaped one. I'm like, it's just cute.
And 50% off, so you can't beat that.
Yeah, so I'm like, I have them.
Heck yeah.
I'm so excited. I never find them. I found one the other day. It was chipped.
Oh no. That's the hardest part with them. That's, I found this one here, this black glass piece here. Oh, is that, yeah, that's dirt. I was going to say, oh.
Oh, yeah.
But, that's dirt too. Okay. But anyways, I pulled his lid up to make sure it was intact.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. To make sure it's not.
Mm-hmm. I've been fooled by that several times.
Oh, yeah, me too.
I think they have $2.99 on that one. I like that. I'm still debating on these. These look like little coasters. Is that what they are? Just little vintage coasters? I don't know. All right, guys, I'm back home from meeting up with Dina over at the Goodwill. Dina from Left Lane Finds. I will put all of her links and everything in the description of the video, so definitely go check out her channel. She does some really good stuff. She has a couple different channels, actually, so go check her out. She's awesome. And what a cool person to go spend the afternoon thrifting with. It was great. I had an amazing time. Let's take a look at what I was able to find at the Goodwill today. I hadn't been there for probably a week and a half or 2 weeks, and knowing that she was coming into town, I kind of wanted to give it a little bit of time to replenish the shelves with new stuff that I hadn't maybe seen for, you know, ever. And so I did. And we went today, and Dina found some great stuff too. I'm going to put a picture real quick of her cart before we left to give you an idea of what all she picked up. First thing here I have is, it's one of these, and I had a video not long ago where I was at Hillcrest Thrift. It's a newer location that opened up in, I believe it's still technically Overland Park. And I found a bunch of these little cookie mold presses from Brown Bag. Brown Bag Cookie Art, Hill Design Incorporated. This one says circa 19, or copyright 1993. And I found a whole big stack of these, and they were mostly Christmas and, I don't know, maybe a couple Valentines or something were in there. And they had like $5 or $5.99 on each one, and so I wound up not getting any of those. But I came across this one today, and this one isn't just the cookie mold, which I loved. I thought was really cool. I suppose this is a along the lines of Valentine's Day one. But it still had the original flippin' cookie recipe book on it, Brown Bag Cookie Art. And sure enough, on the inside are all the recipes. I thought that was adorable. I said, I might make me some sugar cookies tonight based on this. But anyways, especially because it had that, I picked it up, and $2.99. Now, what this particular one will sell for, I don't know. The fact that it still has the little instruction book probably raises its value marginally, I would think. But that was really cute, and it's in great shape. There was no damage to it, so cool. Another item I found for, again, $2.99, was this really cool spoon rest, and it's a little vintage one. It's Cardinal USA impressed on the back there, and so it looks like celery, but it's in great condition. I thought at first this part here was like a chip or something, but really it's just part of the ceramic. I don't know, little piece of ceramic there. And, you know, it needs to be washed or whatever, but it otherwise, as far as I could tell, looked to be in great shape. So, I liked it. Oh, before we go to these guys, let me show you this. Now, I'm not positive the age on this one, but it's a black glass, or I imagine, yeah, an amethyst glass. Because, as we know, black glass is just a very dark amethyst. Oh, it's not going to show you. But anyways, the inside of it looked great. The edges looked great. The lid looked great. Everything looked great. I pulled the tape off the top of it in the store to make sure, because they had $2.99 on this one. Oh, and here, and I'll show you the base. See, I mean, you can tell right here that it's a pressed in mold fashion here. And so that's why I don't think it's terribly old. I could be wrong, but I haven't looked into it yet. But it was so cute, and I love the little finial piece here, and the fact that it's not damaged at all. Like, regardless of its age, it's adorable. So I picked it up for $2.99. Last but not least, and probably for some reason, my favorite pickup today, were these two guys. And the end cap, when you first walk in towards the hard good area in that Goodwill, Dina was looking at that end cap, and I saw one of these guys, I think it was her, sitting down there. And I couldn't tell for sure if that's what she was, but I thought, well, I'll let Dina look around on the shelf and stuff, and if she doesn't pick her up, well, I might look at her later. Now, the girl here does have a glaze chip to her hand right there, which I don't love that fact, but it's not the end of the world. I figured someone who's crafty enough can probably cover that up if they so wanted to. But I think these are Atlantic mold, and then, you know, usually hand painted at home kind of thing. But this guy, as far as I can tell so far, appears to be in great shape. And then I don't remember, are these taper candlestick holders, or are they just figurine decorative things? Because I kind of feel like his maybe you could, but hers is a little bit wide. Oh, looks like she does. Well, that's either a glaze chip right... Oh gosh, it's so small you won't even see it. That's either a glaze chip right here, or it's a glaze skip. Either way, I just thought they were cute. And they were $3.99 each, so I don't know. I went ahead and picked them up. I thought they were adorable. And they're both singing, you know. It's a little early in the season to start going down the Christmas corridor, but I figured I'd go ahead and grab them. So, yeah, that's the extent of my haul today, guys. It wasn't too ambiguous. They had a lot there. There was more that I would have, you know, potentially picked up. There was a lot in the way of, like, dishes, and so I just steered away. I've been listing so many dishes and stuff lately that I just don't care to list another dish, like, to add to my inventory to have to list right now. And so knowing I'm leaving money on the table, it is what it is. The thing is, guys, when you're listing stuff, if you're not feeling the passion for it, you're going to find yourself finding a lot of other things to do other than sitting down and listing. And that's, at least for me, that's how it goes. Because there's always thousands of things going on and that need to get done. And so it's easy to push off listing things that you're not really into listing. And so since I've been doing so much of it lately, I'm kind of tired of it right now. Not that I don't love it, I'm kind of tired of it. So I didn't pick up any to add to the inventory. But you might have seen some in there that looked pretty good. I don't know. Anyways, Dina found some cool stuff. She picked up some cool trinket boxes. She found a good, Revere pan with the copper bottom on it and stuff. She found some good stuff. I was impressed. So, yeah, that was our trip to Goodwill today, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for coming along with us. Definitely go check out Left Lane Finds, her YouTube channel. And she does a couple other channels and stuff too. So go over to her channel and you'll be able to find all that information. But I will link her channel below. But otherwise, guys, I think that's it for this one. And I'll catch you on the next one. Mm-hmm.